I think everyone has settled in first well. The medical team has made sure that they get enough rest to be able to recover from the jet lag. And day two of preparation has been very good. I mean, we've been blessed so far with good weather to be able to start assessing the conditions to see what is it that we need to do. So the build-up so far has been very good, building up to our first warm-up game tomorrow. So we'll see. We'll take it one day at a time and to make sure that the first game comes and we're ready.
They are on basically a daily program. The daily program involves them gymming early in the morning, having a nice healthy breakfast, and then followed by going outside into natural sunlight, decreased melatonin levels, etc. Fresh air. They can come back to the hotel and they generally do an afternoon nap if required, nothing longer than 40 minutes. They don't need to go into the deepest level of sleep. After that, they'll do a nice healthy lunch. Also after about 4 o'clock, no caffeine, no alcohol, no caffeinated drinks or anything like that. So they're not stimulated in that at all. And they also do another gym session, or they'll do a pool session. Just to keep them refreshed. Again, nice healthy supper, preferably low in red meat, because red meat increases the digestive system and basically keeps them awake. I try on the first few days get them to go to bed a bit later, after 9, 10 o'clock, just so they sleep all the way through, because that's the biggest part is the sleep, is adjusting to the different time zones. That's our biggest challenge, traveling against the time zones, because we left on Monday and you actually lose the whole of Tuesday and you arrive on Wednesday, so you've actually lost a full day. The ladies have adjusted extremely well. One or two here and there are struggling with their sleeping patterns, which is completely normal, but generally really happy with the condition of the ladies. The ladies are good, strong, happy. Yeah. The ladies that are returning from injury, obviously we've had them on personalized training programs. We do top-up sessions and that where we're available. We do daily check-ins, check in where they're at, and basically adjust their day-to-day programs. The most essential thing is that relationship that you have with the players, that they are open and honest with exactly how they're feeling, because if you don't know that process, you can't help them. So that relationship and that with them is extremely important. And then we do daily programs, we adjust it daily according to how the players and that are feeling. So extremely happy with the condition of the players.
Conditions have been good and the host have been good. They've given us everything that we asked for, so we can't complain as far as that is concerned. At the end of the day, it boils down to what happens in the middle. I mean, to make sure that the players are ready, everybody's been working around the clock to give them everything that they need. So regarding that, as far as even where Russell is concerned and the medical team, they've been spot on what they need to do with the players. I think the practice matches is mainly to first assess more or less what the conditions will be like, how close is it from home, what we need to adapt in our skills and our plans, and also to make sure that each and every player in the squad gets game time, to make sure that when they get the opportunity to play, they know what is it that they need to do as players and how to execute their skills. And overall, as far as their skills have been concerned, the first 2 days have been very good. I'm impressed with the way how most of them are actually adapting to the conditions. And we had proper discussions as a team on what needs to happen. We know the importance of the tour. So tomorrow will give us time now in the middle to make sure that we rotate the squad and give everyone time.